Nnamdi Kanu must not die in the DSS custody. Nigerian government plan is to kill my husband. Nothing must happen to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu in the DSS custody. This is coming from Uchenna Kanu, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's wife. You know, earlier today, we heard that the IPOB leader collapsed in the DSS custody. And all this is because of his health condition. Whether the federal government is thinking or they just want to buy him in the DSS custody, we don't really understand what they are up to. Because this is a man, they said he have a heart issue. A heart issue is not what you play with. You get a heart issue. Someone who is having a heart issue is not somebody you play with. You will not allow him to go even after he has been discharged. You will not even allow him to take proper care of himself. What exactly is the government of Nigeria looking for in this Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's case? Just like what the wife said, he must not die in the DSS custody because the aftermath is going to be boom. You get. This is not just the issue of the soldiers that be police and when they won't begin to buy people. You get. Why this matter be like this? Like this? Why Nigerian government can never ever go free for this case is because Kanu has been released. This is a country where the government don't obey the rules and regulation of its own land. This is a country where the government do not obey court order, even DSS. It not they happen anywhere. All these things not they happen anywhere. Nigerian DSS not they obey court law. The federal government not they obey court law. If you say this man committed crime against the government and the same Nigerian court, a competent court of jurisdiction that said leave him, let him go, you even have to pay him damages. He said no. No. You will not listen. You will not. In fact, that decision or whatever by the court is not for you until you are fulfilled with whatever. Just like what the woman said. Let me repeat it again. Kanu must not die in the DSS custody. Because not be this one when we talk, now we're going to talk again. You understand? Now here, now they say Nigerian soldiers, they do what they like. Yeah, now I'm army now. Then they do what they like. They do whatever they like. Police, they do whatever they like. They know they obey court order. In fact, these things doesn't happen in a same country. Today we heard that Kenya Inspector General of Police bagged 6 months jail term for defying court orders. We know they hear all this kind of thing for Nigeria. How many times the former DSS boss defied court orders? Apart from even Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's case, the former governor of CBN, and other cases, Sunday Igbowu case and all that. Several times, Omoyele Oshoare case like that. Even other cases. Once they occupy office, they don't assume the position of God. This Kenya Inspector General of Police, he bagged six months jail term for defying court order. The judge at the High Court in Nairobi, Kenya, on Friday sentenced Gilbert Masigeli, the acting Inspector General of Police, to 6 months in prison for defying court orders. Can something like this happen in Nigeria? No. It was learned that the police chief repeatedly defied orders to testify about the whereabouts of 3 men allegedly abducted by police officers. How many we could talk for Nigeria? How many people they don't arrest, then they disappear? And nothing happens. Are we actually a country at all? The presiding judge has also suspended his sentence for 7 days to give Gilbert, the acting Inspector General of Police, a final chance to appear in court before having to report to jail. The case stems from a lawsuit by the court's main bar association, the Law Society of Kenya, which is seeking a court order for the release of 3 men who it said were taken by the police in August and have not been heard from since. So the 3 were outspoken on social media platforms in support of the mass anti-government protests in June and July, the human rights activist says dozens of people involved in the protests were adopted by state agents and held incommunicado. Most were subsequently released. President William Ruto has promised to look into these accusations, although he has boldly defended the conduct of state security service during the protest. The judge, Lawrence, had asked Gilbert to appear in court 7 times to provide the whereabouts of the 3, but Gilbert never did. So in the event that he does not submit himself to the Commissioner General of Prisons, the Minister of Interior must take all steps that are necessary and permissible in law to ensure that Gilbert is committed to prison. He was quoted. So guys, now I don't hear and so now this kind country, now you take the understand, you know, country when we say they work. Country when we say they work. You get. Well, make a drop up for you. Kindly drop your comments below the comment section. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Share this video, let it go viral.